this service is the special excursion to Parsley Sidings.
Welcome to a rediscovered edition of Parsley Sidings with Kenneth Connor, Liz Fraser, Ian Lavender, Elizabeth Morgan, and as the station master, Arthur Lowe.
Parsley Sidings is not British Rail's busiest station, but there's always something going on there. At this moment, porter Percy Valentine has been summoned to the station master's office. Somehow, Valentine has the feeling that today isn't going to be Valentine's Day.
You want to see me, Mr. Hepplewhite?
Yes, Valentine. Come in.
It's not about those crates of whiskey up the waiting room chimney, is it, sir?
Whiskey?
Yeah. Well, I've got an explanation, though, so I've got an explanation, you see. Whiskey. There isn't any whiskey. It's just my little joke. Yeah. Is it about the 3 foot of missing railway line, is it? It's a very simple answer to that, sir.
It's not about missing railway line.
Huh? Oh, well, in that case, good morning, Mr. Hepplewhite.
It's about a book.
Never seen it before in my life.
Oh, stop waffling, man.
What?
Just recently, a most fascinating book has come into my possession.
Oh? Ah, a book, eh? Oh, what? Oh, well, eh? Hmm. One of those with you. Well.
I beg your pardon?
Come on, you can show it to me, Mr. Applewhite. We're all men at a won't.
Here it is. The Businessman's Guide to Commercial Profitability by Walter P. Lunkhammer.
Aye?
It was left on the platform by one of our passengers. It has opened my eyes, Valentine.
Oh, it sounds a riot.
Suddenly, I saw what our railway line lacks.
Passengers.
Precisely. And in this book is the answer to our problem. With modern sales methods, we can make Parsley Sidings a bustling center of railway activity. I quote, go out into your marketplace.
The marketplace? What do you mean, stand out in the marketplace shouting, get your tickets here, lovely tickets. Don't return the waddle on thrash, sold to the lady with a little white basket. Thank you, madam.
Valentine. The marketplace referred to is metaphorical.
Oh.
Houston would scarcely approve of street vending. I mean, we must show that we have something to sell.
Yeah. What?
Parsley Sidings.
Oh, come on, you're not serious.
The image of Parsley Sidings. We are not a busy station, Valentine. And I need hardly remind you that the axe is falling on stations that are not busy.
Well, we've got some regular passengers.
There is always the commuter traffic, it is true. But once old Mr. Wren retires from his office at Potwistle Halt, even that will be cut by half. No, Valentine, something more is called for. And I think I have it. Something to bring the customers back to our station. A Tuesday and Friday special excursion to Biggleswick.
Well, I can't see them actually sort of storming the barriers for that.
You forget, Valentine. Tuesdays and Fridays are market days in Biggleswick.
Yeah. Get out into your marketplace.
Precisely. The women will flock to it, especially when they hear about the special attraction.
Oh, not more.
I see this as a package deal.
Right.
To add a touch of glamour, the ticket will include tea at the Robin Redbreast Tea Rooms in Biggleswick.
Oh, Sodom.
I beg your pardon?
And Gomorrah.
The whole extravaganza will be capped with a late-night show at the Bijou Cinema at about 6:30. Then home again to Parsley Sidings.
Oh, it's got to be a winner, this.
I think one can say that.
Hey, well, how soon do we start, then?
I intend to start right away by visiting Biggleswick this morning. I shall call at the Robin Redbreast and make a deal on the teas. Miss Simpkins will be coming as my secretary, so Hepplewhite Jr. will do the train announcements in her absence.
Hey, do you think that's wise, Mr. Hepplewhite? I mean, last time you bunged him on the train announcements, he lost the timetable, you know. So every train that came in, he yelled, all change, and we ended up with 500 people on the platform. Yeah, three of them on the line.
I remember. For a brief afternoon, it was like the golden days of the railway again.
You sent for me, Father, Mr. Hepplewhite?
Yes, Bertrand. Miss Simpkins will be in Biggleswick this morning. I wish you to take over the announcements.
But what about my booking office?
On the brief occasions you're called away, let down the position closed shutter.
Yes.
But, unlike last time, first take care to withdraw your head.
Yes, Mr. Hepplewhite.
Remember, Hepplewhite, announcements are a key part of public relations. Watch your articulation.
Where do I fit into this fiddle? The scheme, Mr. Hepplewhite.
Yours will be a vital role, Valentine.
Oh, yeah?
According to Mr. Lunkhammer, the poster is all important. You will be our advertising manager.
Posters, eh? Cool. We're going to have a few of them busty brunettes, eh, with the old... Cool.
Valentine. It's the Biggleswick Market Excursion we're selling, not the Kama Sutra.
You just leave it to me, sir. By the time I finish with them posters, they'll be fighting for their seats.
Good. Get Bertram to help you. He will be useful for sticking up posters.
I'd rather use a brush.
I am off now to Biggleswick.
Right.
If anyone wants me, tell them I'm on a trade mission. There we are, Miss Simpkins. The Robin Redbreast tea rooms.
Very quaint, Mr. Hepplewhite. It's a dying craft, you know. That plastic wrought ironwork.
So I believe.
I'm ever so glad you brought me.
I want the woman's point of view.
Oh, yes?
I must be sure that my policy is geared to the media, as Mr. Lunkhammer says.
What does that mean?
Let's go in.
Good morning. Tea for two, is it?
No, thank you. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Horace Hepplewhite, station master of Parsley Sidings, and this is Miss Simpkins, our senior lady porter.
Oh, how do you do?
Charmed, I'm sure.
We've come to discuss the possibility of a British rail party here on Tuesdays and Fridays. I presume I'm addressing the proprietors?
Oh, no, I'm Ethel.
Oh.
But if you hang on, I'll call her. Granny!
Granny?
There's a couple wants to throw a party here from Tuesday to Friday.
Used to be rather an old world atmosphere in here, Miss Simpkins. But I gather it's been taken over by these new people.
Now, what's all this?
Good morning, Horace Hepplewhite.
No. My name's Twillett. Mrs. Twillett, on account of I'm a widow, you see.
Mrs. Twillett, we'd like to arrange for a party of people to eat afternoon tea here on Tuesdays and Fridays as part of a British rail excursion.
Oh, well, it's my mother's the one you want, you see. Only she's on her paper round.
Couldn't you discuss these parties on her behalf?
We could do you a cup of tea and a bun apiece.
How much?
10 pence a head.
Oh, that's not bad.
Plus extras.
What extras?
Well, it's used to the plates. That's 5 pence laid. Then sugar. Well, we normally charge 2 pence a lump for that. Well,
that seems rather high.
Well, there's entertainment included, you see.
Entertainment?
What's in Ethel? Trying to balance a tray full of cups. She sort of pirouettes around the counter, pouring tea all down her arms.
Sounds hilarious.
Is there nothing cheaper?
Oh, there is your popular tea. That's half a bun and no sugar, and that's 17 pence inclusive.
How can you call that popular?
We like it.
Very well, we'll settle that. We shall now go to the Bijou Cinema.
Oh, you like it there?
Really?
Yes, it's run by my uncle.
Indeed. You're not connected with the Mafia by any chance, are you?
Oh, no, why?
Oh, never mind. Just a thought. Come, Miss Simpkins. Sidings ahead, Miss Simpkins. One could hardly call the traders of Biggleswick open-handed.
I thought you did very well, Mr. Hepplewhite. And the film should be a good climax to the whole outing.
I'm still not convinced that Naked on Leather Island is entirely suitable for our excursion. However, I understand the Bijou changed their programs midweek, so the Friday outing will see a different film. Let us hope that it's something with more decorum.
Oh, it is. It's called The Thing Without a Thing.
Perhaps bingo would have been a better idea.
Here we are, Mr. Hepplewhite, home again. And Percy's here to meet us.
Hello, Mr. Hepplewhite. Hello, Gloria.
Good afternoon, Valentine. What's happened to the announcement?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.